It's a big public health debate.
Yes.
You know, the banning of smoking. And on the one hand, you have Liz Truss, who's against it. On the other hand, you have Chris Whitty. I just don't know who to believe.
What do you believe, Ian?
I believe they've identified something that could make health a lot better and a lot cheaper.
Mm.
And Rishi Sunak's trying to do something about it. And, you know, this really hurts being pleasant about the Prime Minister. You've no idea. But I think it might be a good idea. And the rebellion was led by people who want to be Prime Minister. Kemi Badenoch, Penny Mordaunt. Mm.
Kemi Badenoch, I think she was the only Cabinet Minister to rebel against it. So she was saying that she agrees with it in principle, but she doesn't like the execution. And I think the phrase she said was, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. So I feel like we should trust her, because she travels down it to get to work every day.
But a lot of things that are quite fun are also bad for our health.
Yeah, heroin.
Yeah.
Seatbelts in cars.
Yes.
Big fuss about that at the time. That was an infringement of civil liberties to have a seatbelt in a car.
Which individual thought car seats? Cars shouldn't be allowed.
Car seats?
For babies.
Children car seats.
Oh, I see.
Was it Rishi Sunak, because he felt patronised?
The Rwandan scheme is proving quite expensive. It's currently projected to have a base cost of £370 million over the five-year contract. But on top of that, there's an additional charge of £150,874 per migrant deported. Although I've looked into this and they can get £25 off that if they use a voucher code. I've managed to source this one. At the start of the week, Rishi Sunak insisted...
Who is he? Who is Rishi Sunak?
I think he's a cross between a sunbed and an anorak.
No ifs, no buts. These flights are going to Rwanda. Quite a claim. May I suggest, Prime Minister, you ensure they're atoll protected, that you pay for it on a credit card so you have Section 75 protection, and, of course, you pay it off in full.
Oh, it's time now for the missing words round, which this week features as its guest publication, Ratitude. The magazine of the North of England Rat Society. For northerners who don't find pigeons dirty enough. And we start with, Putin is what, says author?
Great bloke and I want to live.
Yeah. Is it gay?
The answer is latently gay, says author. A new biography of Vladimir Putin speculates that he might be latently gay. The biographer is not the first to make this claim. The idea that President Putin is latently has been put forward by a number of recently deceased psychologists. Next, chimps take what?
Is it the fucking piss?
The answer is, chimps take their owners to court.
No, they don't.
This is the story of a court case in New York in which four chimpanzees are seeking to be recognised as humans. The complexities of the chimpanzees' case have left legal experts scratching their heads, rubbing their asses on ropes and eating things from behind each other's ears. Next, from a rat PR point of view, what was very negative?
The bubonic plague.
No, it's the name Red-Eyed Devil. Next, Chinese girl had what in her ear?
British Prime Minister talking patronisingly. Got a flower in her head.
It was a fully grown dandelion. A doctor tried to remove it by blowing. But all that happened was he found out it was 3 o'clock.
He's been charged with lying, hasn't he?
Yes.
With falsifying, with the big bus with the figure outside that was something like £320 billion a week goes through Europe or something like that.
So we'll have to be careful or they'll cut this out. And I don't want anyone to spoil the fun of thinking Boris is going to go to jail for life. So, at the moment, we're just at the preliminary hearing stage.
Oh, right, OK.
About whether, when he was a public official, he was telling lies and therefore abusing his office. It should be an interesting trial. I mean, very similar to putting the Pope on trial and saying, are you a Catholic? he was sacked from then sacked from sacked by his own reprimanded
Ian.
Yes.
We're not allowed to say anything that might prejudice the case.
Well, that's absolutely fair enough, because I would like him to have a fair trial with a desirable result of him being imprisoned forever.
Without wishing to prejudice the outcome of the case.
No, because we mustn't do that. I'm not saying he's guilty.
Would you like to see Boris Johnson?
Let's deal with your arguments. One of them is on the side of this bus. We sent 350 million to Europe. We don't. And you know we don't. No, we don't. You know we don't. Admit that that figure is grotesquely misleading at best.
I went.
The true figure is 161 million, correct?
No, the true figure is 350 million.
In net terms, the real figure is 161.
If you take out the abatement and and the money that comes back, the UK money that comes back via Brussels, the figure is obviously lower.
Matt Lucas is so good.
So where did David Cameron decide to start pumping himself up?
Where
did this happen? Yes. I mean, geographically, where?
Was it in the Gaul area?
He was visiting the Institute of Chartered Accountants.
Oh, yes, ICA.
Oh, that's a really pumped-up kind of place.
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah, do you want to have a little look at this?
Yeah.
And if I'm getting lively about it, it's because I feel bloody lively about it. And if you think I'm going to roll over in the next 10 days and let Ed Miliband and Alex Salmond rack that, you've got another thing coming. Taking a risk, having a punt, having a go. That pumps me up.
I think that passes for hysteria amongst the accountants. Yeah.
As well as being bloody lively and pumped up, what else is David Cameron going to do?
He's not going to put up taxes.
He's not going to put up taxes.
It's more than
but
that,
But how is he going to ensure...
He's going to pass
by an act of Parliament
to stop people like himself putting up taxes. It's the most pathetic gesture I've ever seen. Saying, look, I can't be trusted not to just whack up income tax as soon as I get in, so I'm going to pass a law to stop me. Income tax, VAT and national insurance.
Yeah.
You know, in any government that comes in, historically, the first thing they do is they put up taxes, because they have to. And it's the only year you can do it where you're not worried about the election. So taxes will go up. He'll have to find some other ones. Or break the law and be arrested. Or maybe he knows he's not getting in anyway. Oh, the Kent police.
George Osborne was very good on this in 2009. When, because Brown was talking about passing legislation.
Yeah, Gordon Brown outlawed child poverty.
Yeah.
Gone. Thank God for that. Don't have to worry about that anymore. It's against the law. No, it's finished.
The low point of the media coverage this week, I think, was the analysis of Samantha Cameron's feet.
Oh,
in
yes.
various newspapers where there was a shot of her with her shoes off and there were big close-ups and all the experts were coming in to describe...
They thought it was a slight yellowing of the
definitely
toenails.
Definitely a yellowing and could have been how caused... high heels were damaging her feet.
Was it in the Daily Mail? Was it saying Labour poisons Sam's feet?
which football team does David Cameron support?
Aston Villa.
Mm. Well, he doesn't really know, does he? And he claimed to be an Aston Villa supporter, but then he said this in a speech.
Where you can support Man United, the Windies and Team GB all at the same time. Of course, I'd rather you supported West Ham.
He seemed to realise he'd said the wrong thing.
How did he explain his mistake?
I don't support West Ham or Aston Villa. I'm no interested in football. We played rugger where I come from. But a lot of people watch football, so I pretended to have an interest in it in order to gain their votes.
Yeah, no, it's extraordinary. I mean, I thought it'd be terribly boring, like most conference speeches, but it was just fabulous. And I know a lot of people who are probably nicer than me felt very sorry for her. But I thought it was very, very funny.
It's a bad sign when a cough suite goes down better than you do.
She coughed so much, it felt like she was going to start coughing insects. like an actual horror film.
But it's that moment when you're talking to someone who doesn't really believe what they're saying, and they're saying, yes, I'm really the person for the job. And everything's going great.
Cough Nothing does not do well for female politicians. Her and Hillary Clinton, yeah. Their colds have destroyed them.
Well, Ian Duncan Smith used to cough a lot.
Mm.
Do you remember? He was another successful Tory leader.
He never had it that bad, though.
No, you don't think so?
No, it's a sort of much lower level cough based problem. Theresa May took it to, I mean, she weaponized. That was quite incredible. I can't believe you didn't feel any sympathy for her at all. Not even a scintilla.
Oh dear.
I did.
I think I'm coming across as a bad person.
It was awful. I only felt sorry for her because of Boris. I feel that she's. That was such a bad day that it was almost a win for Boris, and I feel that's the only. So I feel like. I hate him so much that you want her to have a better gig, you know. Why don't she sack Boris?
She can't. She can't, can she, sack Boris?
Why?
Because if she sacks him, he gets to walk away from Brexit while simultaneously being able to claim that if he'd stayed in the government, it all would have gone much better than it's clearly going to go.
You know, she can't allow him the pleasure. It's like, you know, he's essentially an arsonist who wants to come back dressed as a fireman.
Yes. Yes.
Where's the fire?
There was one of her. So, I mean, she's been accused of being robotic. So one of the Conservative backbenchers today was making the rounds in the TV studio, saying she's made of very strong metal, which I thought was.
Well, people say that at a certain point, a prime minister runs out of luck. Oh. It just happens to you when everything's going wrong.
Yeah, it's like the end. It's like the complete end. She's not so much as occupying the office of Prime Minister as haunting it.
I mean, again, it's difficult to make up, but the first letter is F, so it's an F off.
An F off. 15% of respondents to a YouGov poll said that the speech had gone well. 15, which is, there's no way that could just be the cabinet. 15% of people. 15% of people watched that and thought, yes, that's gone rather well. Which makes you wonder what it would take to lower that number from 15%. She could have stood there and melted like the witch at the end of The Wizard of Oz. 12% think it went rather well. She's a puddle on the floor. 10% still think it's gone rather well. It's 15%.
Are you sure that isn't just members of the Labour Party?
What lie did Boris Johnson tell Robert Peston?
Was this the 350 million again?
Linked.
On the NHS?
Linked. Yeah.
Did he say it would be reconsidered?
He said it was in the manifesto.
Yeah.
Did she say it at the manifesto launch?
No. Not only did he lie, but he actually cheated as well. Because he looked at Peston's notes in the hope of finding out what the question was going to be, and he was caught.
I didn't know what cheating you were referring to there.
You've suddenly adopted the character of a northern housewife.
Oh!
Have you heard about... Well, no surprise to me. He was rinsing out his own gloves last Saturday.
We haven't talked about Labour very much, so to head off any accusations of bias...
Are you leaving now to be replaced? The next round will be hosted by Michael Portillo. Come on, we could have a train round.
When it comes to Labour's manifesto promises, how did Shadow Foreign Secretary Emily Thornberry muddy the waters?
Was this Trident?
Yep.
She said there'd be a review, and the review might include scrapping it. Was that the problem?
And do you know who contradicted her and said it was Labour's policy to keep Trident?
Shadow Defence?
The Shadow Defence Secretary, that's right. This was Nia Griffiths, the Shadow Defence Secretary. Emily is not the Shadow Defence Secretary I am.
You're doing it again!
I
don't know who that man was. She was in the pub on Saturday, but it wasn't her husband, I'll tell you that much. I know full well he's got a job in Peterborough.
Has anything happened?
Well, she's been to Brussels and everything
that
has changed.
Every week.
People say, oh, we missed Brexit Day, March the 29th. It's not happened. But if you listen to what they're saying in Brussels, they're saying, well, actually, we might give you another extension and we can still have a Brexit Day. And there are some people there who think, well, let's have it every year, every single March the 29th. Theresa May or somebody like her will trot off to Brussels and say, we'll have another 12-month extension and Brexit will still definitely be happening, but we'll just sort of...
Yeah, you know. And we could tell everyone we've left and then just not mention it again.
Exactly. But Halloween, you know, is the next cut-off. Is October.
Do you think that was a joke by the Europeans?
I think it was a joke. But you've got Tory MPs going around saying, oh, well, we must dress up as something for Halloween, you know.
How about as MPs?
Well...
That's the former Prime Minister.
That's the 1922 committee. Yeah.
That's the Queen. No, that's Andrea Leadsom. Oh, God.
At time of recording, who's Prime Minister?
Boris Johnson.
It is currently Theresa May.
Oh, right, of course.
Yeah, but how bad have things got for Theresa May?
There's been another cabinet revolt. She won't even see her main ministers. She's now got a cabinet of two, herself and her husband. even he's walking out. Everyone's gone. Andrea Leadsom's gone, you saw there.
Do you know what number Andrea Leadsom is on the resignation list under Theresa May? How many have gone?
36.
She's the 36th minister. There's a graph from the BBC.
A graph on a comedy show? This is a third.
This is a graph of ministerial resignations before Theresa May, and here it is with Theresa May on it.
This is Theresa May's plan to end the Brexit deadlock. According to the Sunday Times, Philip May's emphasis has shifted to hoping his wife can escape from number 10 with dignity. Sorry, Phil, but however she finally goes, Colonel Gaddafi left with more dignity.
Quite right.
Brexit has clearly put a strain on Theresa May's marriage, but there's no way they'll split up, as Philip May knows negotiating a divorce deal would take years, and he'd need the support of Jeremy Corbyn. According to The Telegraph, MPs are sitting in the longest parliamentary session since the English Civil War. Or, as future historians will call it, English Civil War I.
The director of the Paris Archdiocese, Philippe de Couvreville, told The Times, "We tend to wait for things to become catastrophic before we take care of them." To which Theresa May replied, "Oh, you too."
If you really want to know what the members of the cabinet are thinking, you have to watch Newsnight.
Yes.
And listen to Nicholas Watt.
I said to one cabinet minister, "Why is the Prime Minister holding a vote when she's pretty sure that she's going to lose?" And using very strong language, this cabinet minister said to me, "Fuck knows, I'm past caring. It's like the living dead in here." Oh.
Following a tense meeting of the 1922 committee, evidence emerges as to who ate Sir Graham Brady's donut. Rees-Mogg was obviously very appalled by all this, but he does have his Facebook supporters group to boost his morale. Have you seen his Facebook?
No, well, it's actually been outlawed because it's based in Broadmoor.
Let's have a look at this illuminating forum. Just for interest's sake, are there any young folk on this site? Yes, I'm 55.
What has Boris done for the second time in 6 months?
Nothing.
Gone home in the same direction?
Finally, 72-year-old becomes the oldest competitor in what?
Young Conservatives leadership.
So this is the news that scientists have released the first ever picture of a black hole.
Theresa May is very excited about this because it's a whole new entity out there with which we might do a trade deal in due course. And she's just glad there's another despairing vortex sucking in all human life and light from which there is no escape.
So as the good ship Theresa sinks slowly beneath the waves, who are the latest Tories to thrust themselves forward?
Oh, I don't like that expression. I don't think anybody in the Tory party can thrust. I don't think they've got their own hips. I think everyone who's been elected ever as a Tory thinks I could do a better job than Theresa May. I mean, they're not wrong.
I think you have to have a photo shoot in your kitchen to get into the race.
Yes. This is James Brokenshire. Here he is, with his Meg.
Oh, that is a lovely
That's
kitchen.
Him. I know. And he's Count the ovens, Tom. Count the ovens.
Four ovens.
That we know of. There could be more.
There could be more. That come.
It was George Eustace who quit as farming minister in February. So let's see a colleague in the Scottish Parliament's alarmingly frank assessment of him.
I personally have met with Andrea Leadsom and I've had two meetings with George Eustace.
Evidence emerges to show why agreeing even the most basic of trade deals has taken Liam Fox such a long time. There's Gavin Williamson walking.
which is something he's not denying.
And that's a brilliant bit of dramatised leaking.
Yeah. Oh, Helen Mirren's stuck for work. She's... Gavin Williamson has been fired for allegedly leaking secrets, but he swears on his children's life that it wasn't him. And he has been fired by Theresa May, which is unusual because she loves not firing people. Mm. She's a big fan of just letting people stay, Chris Grayling.
Normally, you know, if you sacked your defence secretary, it would be three volumes of a history book. But with this government, yeah, all right, he's gone.
Theresa May seems so definite that he did it that I'm assuming he didn't.
This is the news that Gavin Williamson has been sacked as Secretary of State for Defense over the Huawei leak. As The Guardian put it, Williamson is the first cabinet minister to go for a leak since 1986. How has Williamson responded?
He accused her of ingratitude. He said, "I've saved your career twice," as though anyone's going to be grateful for that.
Yeah, that does mean prison, I think. He admits to that.
I think maybe he did it, he just didn't realise, because he seems very adamant that he did not do it. Yeah. If you're going to swear on your children's life, that's...
Yeah, I don't think we should hold him to that.
But he said it, Andy. Oh. He said it.
Well, it's fine, though. He doesn't have any kids. There you go.
Not anymore.
Or he won't.
Johnny, yeah. You were in the army.
Yeah.
You sit on that committee. Is this a good idea?
No, I mean, it doesn't sound great, but the people who know this stuff seem to think it's all right, but, you know...
You don't sound totally lukewarm, even.
my political vim and vigour is on its last legs, I think. Much like the government.
Rest of the world.
Theresa Mayhem in her £900 coat. There she is, flying off to Brussels to be told what to do and say and think. The real Prime Minister.
On the left.
The traitor's kiss. The Politburo, or is that Bexley Heath Council? And a man on a bike.
How do the rival camps calling Jeremy Hunt?
Sounds like.
I got it. Apparently, Jeremy Hunt is called Theresa in trousers, or tit for short. Did you see how Liz Truss dealt with the question on LBC?
No, but I can't wait.
What do you think of having another EU referendum?
A very, very, very bad idea.
But people can change their minds, can't they?
But they were told in the referendum in 2016 that their vote would be implemented, and the reality is the vote needs to be implemented.
But what about the people who like changed the answer, their minds between then and now?
I don't think people have changed their minds. Everyone
you have.
I speak to. I have, that's true.
Who are you backing in the Conservative leadership election?
There isn't one. There isn't a Conservative leadership.
Should
election.
There be one in the near future, if that's something we could.
I don't know if that's going to happen.
What are they doing running around trying to get each other's votes then?
You're not going to believe this, but some of my colleagues are slightly more fixated with their own careers than what's going on in Brexit.
I know. Now that shock. Is shocking,
right? absolute shock. So yeah, some people are running around trying to be prime minister at a time of national crisis,
including Mrs. May.
Theresa May still have support among the grassroots outside the Westminster bubble. How did she get on in Wales this week?
She got heckled.
Yes, she did, didn't she?
Yep, she made a speech to local party activists. Everything went well for the first 5 seconds. Then...
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, and...
Why don't you resign?
Well, she did a bit of Welsh there. At least she knows how to say what a knobhead in Welsh, so that's handy.